Now I will teach and explain you the last and fourth part of past tense. That is part of perfect continuous tense. Part of perfect continuous tense is the fourth and last part of past tense. It is used to indicate a running action with a point or period of time in the past tense or previous tense. It means we use part of perfect continuous tense to show a running action in the previous time or past time with that action, running action must be continuing with the point of time or period of time. And to show or indicate the running action with point of time or period of time, we use two kinds of adverbs. They are since and for. We use since and for in past perfect continuous tense, just like present perfect continuous tense. Since we use with the point of time like morning, like since morning, since evening, since noon, since night, any season, since summer, since winter, month of the year, since January, since December, any kind of year, since 2016, since 1947, etc. So these types of time string words, they indicate or show point of time. Our next adverb in part of the continuous tense is for, and we use for with the period of time. Means period of time is indicated or shown by using for, like 5 days, 2 months, 3 weeks, 4 years, etc. It means we use for to indicate a period, a long period that is not particular. So for is used with period of time. Helping verb in past perfect continuous tense is only one, helping. It means we use helping as a helping verb with all types of subjects, whether they are singular or plural. With all types of subjects, singular or plural. Yes, students. Now I will explain you sentence structure with examples in the past perfect continuous tense. We take simple sentence. In simple sentence, we will follow this structure in past perfect continuous tense. First of all, subject will be done. Then we use had been with all kinds of subjects. Because in past perfect continuous tense, there is only one helping verb, had been. So had been will be used with all types of subjects, whether they are singular or plural. Then main verb is written with ing form. We will use first form of verb with ing, then object, then other words or complementary verbs if any, and after other words we will use since or for plus time and full stop at last. We have some examples of simple sentence. They have been watching a movie since morning. In this sentence, the action of watching a movie was going on with a point of time. So this is written in past perfect continuous tense. Following this structure, there is subject, had been, helping verb. First form is watch. It is used here with ing. Written here with ing, watching a movie is object. And there are no other words after object. Adverb is used since, because the timing is point of time. This time is a point of time, so since is used here. It means the action of watching a movie was going on since morning in the previous or past time. We take the next example. He had been living there for last 5 years. The action of living there was going on for a period of time. That is period of time. In the above sentence, that is point of time. So he is subject here, helping verb, had been. First form verb is live with ing, living there. There is other word. In this sentence there are no objects, only there, and there is other word. For is adverb, because the timing is in the form of period. last 5 years. Last 5 years, they are showing a period of time. So, for as an adverb is used here. To take the next example, we have been studying here since 2002. In this sentence, the action of studying was going on since 2002. We subject have been studies first form with ing. There is other word. No object is there since is adverb because 2002 is point of time. So since as an adverb is used here and full stop at last. Now we take the next sentence structure, negative sentence. A negative sentence in past perfect continuous tense will follow this structure. Firstly, we have to use subject, then have not been. Because in negative sentence, we use not after helping verb. In this tense, had is our helping verb. So, not is set between had and been. So, in negative sentence, we will use had not been. That means, we have to set not between had and been. Then the remaining structure will be the same, just like simple sentence, first form with ing, object, other words or complementary words, if any, since, for, plus time and full stop. There are some examples of negative sentence. They had not been playing games there since noon. There is subject here. In this sentence, the action of playing games was going on with a point of time in the previous period or past period. There is here subject, had not been, had is helping verb, not been, not here, said between had and been. So they had not been. First form of verb, play with ing, playing, games. Games is object. And there is other word. Games is object and there is other word. Since is adverb and noon is time. Noon is point of time. So before point of time, we always use since as an adverb. We take the next example. He had not been taking his meal for 10 minutes. In this sentence, the action of taking meal was not going on with a period of time. This is period of time. He is subject, negative sentence. So had not been is used here. Take is first form of verb with ing, taking his meal, his object, for is adverb. We have used here for because the timing is period. 10 minutes. 10 minutes are showing a period. So for is used here. We take the last example of 90 seconds. I have not been reading the book since 8 p.m. In this sentence, the action of reading the book was not completed. Means it was going on with a point of time, 8 p.m. The action of reading the book in the previous time or past period was going on with a point of time, 8 p.m. I subject had not been is used here. Read is the first form of verb with ing, reading. The book is our object, since, adverb. We have used here since because the time is given in the point. This is point of time, 8 p.m. So since is written. So students, in simple sentence and negative sentence, the important things are, in simple sentence, we just use had been plus first form of ing, and in negative sentence, we will use had not been plus first form of ing. Remaining structure will be the same. Yes, students, they are the sentence structures with examples in past perfect continuous tense. Firstly, introductory sentence. In introductory sentence, we have to follow this structure. We start with had because had is our helping verb. So we have to start with had in an introductory sentence. After had, we use had, and after subject, we use been. It means between had and been, we have to set our subject. Then First form of verb with ing, then object, then other verb or complementary verb, if any. And after that, we use since or for according to our time. Means our time is period, then we use for. If our time is point, then we use since. And at last, we use question mark in interrogative sentence. They are examples of interrogative sentence in past perfect continuous tense. Had Mr. Sharma been working there since last year? In this sentence, it is being asked whether Mr. Sharma was working there or not with a particular point of time, means last year. So, we are following here this structure. We have to start with helping verb had, then our subject Mr. Sharma, and then been, means had, been, subject. This is had and this is been, and between had and been we have said here our subject Mr. Sharma. Then first form with ing, work is first form, working ing form, there is our object, and in this sentence there are no other words. Since is our adverb, because last year is point of time, and this is question mark. We take the next example of interrogative sentence. Had they been running a school for 5 years? In this sentence, it is being asked whether they were running a school or not. Means action of running school was going on in the previous time, and this is past perfect continuous tense because time is attached. This is period of time. So, following the structure, had our subject, had is our helping verb. We will start with helping verb had. They is our subject and be. So, between had and be, we have said our subject they. Then, first form of verb with ing, running. Our school is our object. There are no other words in this sentence. This is adverb 4 because our time is in period. 5 years. 4, 5 years. And question mark. Now we get the last sentence structure of past perfect continuous tense, interrogative negative sentence. In interrogative negative sentence, there is both negativity plus interrogation. So we follow the structure. We start with had because this is also an interrogative sentence. So we will start with had, then we use our subject, and then we use not. Just like the structure of a negative sentence, we have to use our not after subject. Then be. It is important to note in the structure. In interrogative negative sentence, we will start with had, then our subject will come, then not will come, then be will come. Then the remaining structure will be the same. First form of ing, object, other words, if any, since, for, plus time, and question mark. In interrogative negative sentence, we use question mark at last. Now we take these examples of interrogative negative sentence in past perfect continuous tense. Had your family not living in Rajasthan since last year? So, had. We have started here with had. This is our helping verb. Your family is subject and not is said after subject, and living there. Been living here in Rajasthan since last year, question mark. And in next example, मतलब इसमें ये पूछा गया है कि क्या आप कोई काम कर रहे हैं जी, क्या आप कोई काम कर रहे हैं, तो वो काम क्या किसी टाइम के साथ चल रहा है? पास्ट टेंस, जैसे पास्ट टेंस में होता है, पास्ट टेंस के अंदर कोई भी काम हम चल रहा है उसमें अगर टाइम अटैच है तो पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस हम यूज करते हैं. लेकिन पास्ट सिंपल टेंस है उसके अंदर टाइम अटैच नहीं होता है, मीन्स कोई भी जो काम है वो रनिंग कंडीशन में होता है लेकिन उसमें टाइम अटैच नहीं होता है. और पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस के अंदर एक टाइम पीरियड को अटैच कर दिया जाता है. तो उसी अकॉर्डिंग इसके अंदर हम काम करते हैं. Had your family not been living in Rajasthan since last year? अब इसमें जो last year word है वो ये हमें बता रहा है कि इसको जो चल रही बता रहे कि आपकी जो फैमिली है वो राजस्थान में रह रही है वो पिछले साल से रह रही है. और ये जो last year word है वो एक तरह से पॉइंट को बताया कि पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट है लास्ट में, लेकिन जब हम फॉर यूज करते हैं तो उसमें ऐसा टाइम हो जाता है जो लंबा टाइम होता है, पीरियड को शो करता है, इसमें परफेक्ट टाइमिंग का पता नहीं होता है। नेक्स्ट, हैव देयर अंकल नॉट बीन टीचिंग एट दैट स्कूल फॉर टू इयर्स, बीन विल कम, वी विल फॉलो द स्ट्रक्चर हैड प्लस सब्जेक्ट नॉट प्लस बीन, फर्स्ट फॉर्म विद आईएनजी ऑब्जेक्ट अदरवाइज इज फॉर प्लस टाइम। अब यहां जैसे सेंटेंस में लिखा गया है कि क्या आपके अंकल उस स्कूल के अंदर दो सालों से नहीं पढ़ा रहे फॉर टू इयर्स, तो यहाँ पर वो टू इयर्स का पीरियड है, वो एक पीरियड शो कर रहा है, ये जो टाइम है पीरियड को शो कर रहा है, इसमें ये पता नहीं है कि जो टीचिंग का काम है वो दो साल के अंदर कब से स्टार्ट हुआ, एग्जैक्टली ये पता नहीं है जनवरी से या फरवरी से, तो एक पीरियड यूज इसमें किया जा रहा है, एग्जैक्ट पॉइंट क्या है टाइम का वो पता नहीं है, तो फॉर यहाँ पर यूज हो गया। इसमें बेसिकली हम यही देखते हैं कि सिंस और फॉर जो होते हैं वो आपको टाइम से पहले यूज करना है, अगर आपको जो टाइम आपको पता है पर्टिकुलर टाइम है तो उसमें हमें फॉर यूज करना है, और अगर पर्टिकुलर टाइम के बारे में पता नहीं है तो हम फॉर यूज करेंगे, पर्टिकुलर टाइम के बारे में पता है तो हम सिंस यूज करेंगे। जैसे इस एग्जाम्पल में लास्ट ईयर है तो लास्ट ईयर पर्टिकुलर टाइम को बता रहे हैं कि जो ये एक्शन है लिविंग का राजस्थान में वो लास्ट ईयर से चल रहा है, और ये स्कूल है इसमें टीचिंग का जो काम है वो दो सालों से चल रहा है। नेक्स्ट, है रमेश नॉट बीन वर्किंग, बीन विल कम हियर सब्जेक्ट एंड देन नॉट एंड देन बीन, सो है रमेश नॉट बीन वर्किंग एट दैट कंपनी सिंस 2015। अब इसमें जो 2015 लिखा है वो एक पॉइंट है, तो किसी बताया जा रहा है कि कंपनी में जो काम करने का पीरियड है वो एक एग्जैक्ट है, परफेक्ट पीरियड है 2015, तो इसके अंदर हमें सिंस यूज किया है यहाँ पर, या हमने फॉर यूज किया है क्योंकि पर्टिकुलर टाइम नहीं बताया है, दो साल का पीरियड है इसलिए पर्टिकुलर ईयर है 2015, तो साल 2015 से दिया हुआ है। सब्जेक्ट के साथ हम हेड यूज करेंगे क्योंकि हमारा सब्जेक्ट से सिंगुलर प्लूरल हेड से स्टार्टिंग करना है, फिर हमने नॉट सेट किया और उसके बाद में बीन के साथ में फर्स्ट फॉर्म की तारीख थी और इसमें हमारा ऑब्जेक्ट नहीं है, उसके साथ में हमें अदर वर्ड है एट दैट कंपनी और उसके साथ में हमने एडवर्ब यूज किया है सिंस प्लस 2015 और क्वेश्चन मार्क। तो इसमें हमें एक चीज देखनी है कि पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस और पास्ट सिंपल टेंस दोनों में जो मेजर डिफरेंस है वो है सिंस और फॉर। सिंस और फॉर के अंदर हमें ध्यान रखना है कि अगर किसी भी एक्शन का जो पास्ट में चल रहा है उसका हमें अगर परफेक्ट टाइमिंग के बारे में पता है तो सिंस यूज करेंगे, और अगर परफेक्ट टाइमिंग के बारे में नहीं जानते हैं तो फॉर यूज करेंगे। फॉर यूज करने का एक और फॉर्मूला इसके अंदर कि हम देख सकते हैं कि टाइम को क्या हम काउंट कर सकते हैं, जैसे स्थिति में एग्जाम्पल लिखिए इसमें आप देखिए 5 ईयर, तो यहाँ पर 5 को 5 एक नंबर दी गई, मतलब इस टाइमिंग को हम काउंट कर रहे हैं, तो जहां पर भी टाइम को काउंट किया जा सकता है वहां हमें अनवर फॉर यूज करना है, और जहां हमें लगता है कि जो टाइम है वो काउंटेबल नहीं है उसको हम काउंट नहीं कर सकते हैं पीरियड के फॉर्म में दे रहे हैं तो हमें वहां पर फॉर यूज करना है। कि देखिए यहाँ पर 4 ईयर्स है तो ये काउंट ये नंबर आ गया यहाँ पर 5 ईयर, तो यहाँ पर 4 यूज हो गया। इस सेंटेंस में देखिए आप नंबर नहीं है, इसी तरह से इसमें यहाँ नंबर दी गई टाइम के साथ, तो जहां पर भी आपको नंबर नजर आती है वहां हम फॉर यूज करते हैं, अगर नंबर नहीं है तो हम सिंस को यूज करते हैं। आई थिंक यू हैव अंडरस्टूड ऑल दी एग्जांपल्स वेल, और लास्ट में मैं आपको जो बताना चाहता हूँ कि पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस और पास्ट सिंपल टेंस दोनों में जो मेजर डिफरेंस होता है वो होता है टाइम का। पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस के अंदर टाइम नहीं होता है, मतलब कोई एक्शन है वो पास्ट टेंस से चल रहा है बट नॉट इन पर्टिकुलर और पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, मतलब उसमें टाइम मेंटेन नहीं होता है, लेकिन पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस में कोई एक्शन पास्ट में चल रहा है उसमें टाइम क्या होता है कि कोई काम कितने टाइम से हो रहा है कितने टाइम से चल रहा है, तो इसमें टाइम अटैच होगा। थैंक यू।